This laboratory is run by robots. These silicon scientists are executing thousands of experiments, searching for life-saving drugs, and building synthetic organisms, all with virtually no human intervention. It's part of an industry-wide push to move away from time-intensive manual benchwork and towards automation. This has the potential to transform how we develop new therapies and could fundamentally reimagine scientific discovery.
The life sciences is really underserved by automation and technology in general. If you go into a lab, you'll see humans doing a lot of labor-intensive work. There's like a joke that PhD students are kind of free labor for professors. When I was doing my PhD, that's actually when I first started using Strateos' robotic cloud lab myself. The concept was that you could log in to a web application, design an experiment with code, and then have it executed for you by robots remotely via the internet. So I got really excited, and so I signed up. I remember just sort of watching this experiment execute whilst I was just sort of relaxing. And I thought, wow, this is the future of life science. This is really about helping humans focus more on the creative aspects of hypothesis generation and scientific interpretation than the moving small amounts of liquid around or shining lasers at them.
Not only does offloading experimental work onto robots have the potential to save enormous amounts of time, it could also mean more reliable results.
Often, when you look at a protocol that a human is executing, there's very ambiguous steps like incubate overnight, which is no set period of time, or shake until the solution is cloudy. There's no real definition of cloudy or how much you should shake that sample. Every experiment that Strateos executes is actually defined by code. And so when I want my colleague to replicate an experiment that I've performed, I can just give them access to that code and they can just click go and it runs exactly the same way.
So the first step in getting robots to do your scientific bidding, log on to a website.
You actually see a whole menu of different scientific processes that you can choose from. After you've put in all your parameters of the experiment and you've also chosen your samples as well, you click launch, and then our system actually automatically checks that you're not trying to pipette a crazy amount of liquid or you're trying to use something dangerous. And then if it's all good, our system automatically dispatches the work down to the robots. Okay, so we're inside one of our work cells. So this is the robotic arm. You can see it's coming towards us. And this arm has been told to move around this plate in particular. So there's experiments all in this little plate. Once that comes out, this plate is actually then going to go to an analytical device. Meanwhile, the robot is then going to go off and do some other experiments for a different user. Once it's done, the user gets a notification via their email, and they can just go in and fetch their results.
At optimal conditions, a single work cell could execute 190,000 experiments in a day, and Strateos currently has 23 work cells in operation.
We really believe that this is going to go more and more towards the types of scale that cloud computing has reached. You could picture a huge warehouse type facility packed full of robotics and inventory and storage equipment for samples, and then thousands of scientists all using that equipment and infrastructure simultaneously remotely via the internet.
Faster, easier, and more reliable experimental results would be a game changer across industries, but one that could benefit most is drug discovery.
The process of developing drugs has become extremely difficult. We start by identifying a target that we're looking to develop a drug or some other therapy for. So we design that assay for the target, and it will tell you whether or not the activity of that particular target has been inhibited or not, and then screen that over many, many possible compounds, many possible drugs.
It can take years of experiments and cost billions of dollars to develop a single drug. And often after all of that, it could fail before getting to market. Using a cloud lab could help drug developers streamline that process.
We've been able to work with Eli Lilly in actually adding synthetic chemistry to the platform. So what that means is that entirely via the cloud, users will be able to design molecules, have them made and purified, and then ran through those biological assays so that they can get that whole process from their idea to data. It's not just large pharma and biotech that have access to this. This platform basically offers state-of-the-art equipment that's typically only been accessible to the big guys. I mean, it actually makes it easier for either startups or academics to have access to this. COVID has been a really interesting time for Strateos. The number of people that have reached out to us saying, hey, my lab is suddenly closed. I need to keep this work going over this time. I think people have seen the need to be able to work remotely with their experiments. Science should be able to continue without physical access to a lab.
Automating the execution of experiments is a huge step towards more efficient and accessible scientific discovery. But some want to go even further to develop robots that actually design their own experiments.
So a key concept in automated science is the idea of a closed loop for experimentation. Closed loop experimentation starts with execution of some set of experiments. The second step is to build a model from that data. And then the third step is to decide what experiments should I do next in order to optimally improve that model.
This loop relies on the union of robotics, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. And getting it right could completely upend how we find life-saving drugs.
So you can think of this like playing the game of Battleship, right? So you've got X and Y coordinates, X being the drugs and Y being the targets. And we're playing the game by doing A1, B1, C1, D1. And if anybody's ever played Battleship, you know that's not a winning strategy. What we really need is to explore the board and then build a model as you're doing that and use that in order to make your next choice. That's where automated science comes in, to tackle the creation of a full predictive model for the experimental space of drugs and targets.
In the future, the same method could be expanded to build predictive models for the complex interactions within our bodies, giving us a much clearer understanding of how they work and what to do when they don't. But there's still a ways to go.
Moving towards the future of automated science, one of the challenges, of course, is a technical one. How do we implement this for many different kinds of experimental spaces, for different cells, for tissues, for whole organisms? And so that, of course, is going to take an enormous amount of work. But there is also a real bottleneck there in the adoption of this automated science approach by scientists. I thought that a good place to start would be by building a master's program in automated science. The first class just finished their first year.
Those are going to be some of the most productive scientists around because they'll be able to scale their experiments through code and automation. And also be able to scale the actual data analysis piece as well.
A lot of people ask me, what's the role for humans if you've eliminated humans from the loop? I think that one answer to that kind of question is the same answer that's been given to automation for hundreds of years, which is that automation doesn't replace the need for people. It changes the jobs that people do.
Now a PhD student themselves could be their own PI of all of these different robots doing experiments for them. So they can actually have much grander aspirations of the hypotheses that they want to evaluate and the scale of experimentation that they want to accomplish.